Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to our channel. So today we'll discuss one more question from the previous year CSIR NET physical science. So there is a question that it says the Hamiltonian of two interacting particle with spin 1 and spin half is given by H is equal to, so there is a Hamiltonian H is equal to A S1 dot S2 plus B S1x plus S2x. Okay, so this is the Hamiltonian of two interacting particle with spin half and spin 1. Okay, and this S1 is the spin operator for spin 1 particle. Okay, I'm not writing the question. And S2 is the spin operator for spin 2 particle. This is the question. And the question is to find out the largest eigenvalue of the Hamiltonian. So we have to find out the eigenvalue for this Hamiltonian. Okay, so this is the Hamiltonian, and S1 and S2 are the spin operator of spin 1 and spin 2 particle. Spin 1 particle, this is spin, second particle is spin half particle. Okay, so the spin half particle, and B is, and A and B are two positive constants. Okay, so we have to find out the largest eigenvalue of the Hamiltonian. So this is the question of previous year 2019 net question. Okay, so before going to solve the question, we know that the spin operator is as components, this S1x and X2x. See, there are S1x and X2x. These are the component of the spin operator. Okay, we know that if we are just, I am discussing something related to this question. So S is the spin, the component of this S vector is vector are Sx, Sy and Sz. This is the spin. And similarly for orbital angular momentum, we will have Lx, Ly, Lz, like those. Okay, so Sx, Sy and Sz. So just we have to find out what will be the eigenvalues. Okay, so this S1 is nothing but my spin half particle. Okay, and S2 is nothing but half, spin half. So these are two particles, one is spin 1 and having spin 1 and having spin half particles, they are interacting with each other. Okay, so the spin will be, total spin will be 3 by 2 and 1 by 2. So the question is to find out the largest eigenvalues. Okay, so for largest eigenvalues, we have to take the largest spin of these two interacting particles. Okay, so after that, see, and we know, see the first part. Okay, we are going to solve this part by part. Okay, so this first part is A S1 dot S2, and we know that this S1 S2, we'll see, we'll multiply this letter. Okay, so S1 and S2 is nothing but S square 1 by 2 S square minus S1 square, or I can write only S1 square without the symbol, so also, and S2 square. Okay, so see, we know that S is nothing but H cut under root S into S plus 1. So similarly for S1 and S2. See, so the my largest, it was asking for largest eigenvalue. That's why I am taking the larger value of this, total spin of these two interacting particles. Okay, so if I'll substitute here, I will get half, S is nothing but 3 by 2. So I will get here 3 by 2 into 3 by 2 plus 1, right, into h cut square. So I'm taking the h cut square outside. Okay, so 3 by 2, and here also I will get S1. S1 is nothing but the spin 1 particle. So I will get here 1 into 1 plus 1 minus here half into half plus 1. Okay, and h curve square, I have already taken it out outside. Okay, so h curve square by 2, here I will get 2 18 by 4, I hope. Let's check it. 2, 3, 3 plus 5, 5 by 2. So this will be 15. 15 by 4 minus 2 minus, this will be 3 by 4. Okay. So here I will get h curve square by 2. This is 4, 15 minus 8 minus 3, that will be equal to 11 h curve square by 8. Okay, so I got s1 dot s2 is equal to 11 h curve square by 8. Let's check this one more time. 15 minus 11, so here I will get 4. Okay, here I will get, okay, this is 15 minus 4, 8 minus 3. So that is 8, 11, 15 minus 11, I will get 4, 4. So h curve square by 2, here I will get 1, okay. So 1, so I will got a h curve square by 2. So a s1 dot s2, I got a h curve square by 2. Okay, so I got here a h curve square by 2. So my first part is this much, a h curve square by 2. For the second part, which is b s1x plus s2x, so I have to check this now, s1x plus s2x. See, if I know s, the component of s are sx, sy and sz. So for to find out sx, I know that sx square is nothing but s square minus sz square. Okay, so from where sz is nothing but m s h cut. Okay, this is the azimuthal part. Okay, sz is equal to m s h cut. So similarly, if there is sy also, sy square is nothing but s square minus sz square. Okay, so they both are equal. See, to find out s1x, that is, this is for spin 1. So for s1x, I will get s1x square. S square will be equal to 1 plus 1 h cut square. Because here this is nothing but, if I am getting s1, see, if I am finding out for s1, that this will be s1 square minus s1z square. Okay, so s1 is nothing but h cut square, h cut into root over s1, s1 plus 1. So okay, so from here I will find out s1. S1 is for 1, so that is 2 h cut square. Okay, 2 h cut square, s1 1, here I will get root 2 h cut, and s1 square is 2 h cut square minus here s1 z. I will get s z is nothing but m s h cut, and this m s value is plus or minus s, right? This plus m s value is plus or minus s. So from there I will get my ms value is plus, I am taking plus values. So ms, m1s I will get here, s is equal to 1, so I will get 1. Okay, so here ms, sz value is ms h cut square, so I got 2 h cut square minus h cut square, here h cut square. So s1x is equal to h cut. Similarly, I can find out s2x square, that is nothing but s2 square minus s2z square. Okay, so s2 square will be nothing but 3 by 4 h cut square, and here as s2 is equal to half, ms will be also half. Okay, plus or minus half, so I am taking the positive value, half. So I will get here h cut square by 2. So here I am getting h cut square by 4. Okay, So here 4, 3 minus 2 h cut square. So I will get h cut square by 4 here. Okay. Just a second, huh? H cut square by 2 here, and h2x value will be root over of this, that is h cut by 2. Okay, so I got h cut by 2 here. So just I will substitute here. The second part of the equation is b s1x plus s2x, right? Sorry. Okay, so I'm taking the whole equation. So h is equal to a s1 dot s2 plus b s1x plus s2x. Here I got a h cut square by 2. See, I have already solved this one, this part, a h cut square by 2, plus here I got b s1x plus s2x, that is h cut plus h cut by 2. Okay, so I got a h cut square by 2 plus here this is 3b h cut by 2. So if I will take 1 by 2 outside, a h cut square plus 3b h cut. Okay, 3b h cut. So this is my eigenvalue for the Hamiltonian operator, this particular Hamiltonian operator. This is this option is there. Okay, so this is the Hamiltonian for the, sorry, this is the eigenvalue of this Hamiltonian. H is equal to a s1 dot s2 plus b s1x plus s2x. Okay, so similarly if there is l, and we can find out for j, this is, okay, also we can find out if there is a Hamiltonian given. So just doing such type of math, I can find out the eigenvalues of that particular Hamiltonian. Okay, thank you everyone.